15,000 fans on hand, the second largest Expos home crowd this season. Martinez got off to a pretty good start. Vladimir Guerrero here in the second. Ring him up, sit him down. Martinez struck out 10 of the game. Bottom four, it's 1-0 Montreal. Guerrero, a lot better this at bat. Base hitting, went 2-for-4 in the game. Damon Buford fielding, throwing home. Rondo White developing situation at the plate. In there, 2-0 Montreal. Top six, Mike Stanley is going to step up for Boston. And what do we have, fair or foul? It is foul. A homer would have tied the game. Later in the same at bat, Stanley with another chance. Drills it to center. Rondell White efforting. Great effort. That ends the inning. Bottom six, still 2-0 game. Bases loaded. Michael Barrett at the plate. Hanging curveball, base hit. That scores two. And at this point, it is 4-0 in favor of Montreal. Bottom eight, it's 8-1 Montreal. Relief pitcher Guillermo Mota doing some things we didn't think he could do. First major league at bat, gone. Three-run home run. The converted shortstop, remember, he's a relief pitcher. First at bat in the majors, home run, and the Expos win it 13-1. Martinez did strike out 10, but his nine-game winning streak is over. He gave up four runs in six innings. Time.
Mel Stottlemyre back in the Yankee dugout. Took a liner to the head in batting practice on Tuesday. 1-0 Philly, two on for Tino Martinez. Home run. Three-run homer, 10th of the year. 3-1 the Yanks in front. Now fifth inning, 3-2 Yanks. David Cohn, bases loaded against him. Walks Scott Rowland. Chad O.J. comes in to tie the game at 3. 5 2/3 innings, 5 earned runs against Cohn. Remember the 9-run seventh for the Phils on Tuesday? The Yanks go to the 6. Derek Jeter and Bernie Williams. Paul O'Neill a triple. Scott Brosius single. Chuck Knobloch moved in the order. He doubles, or rather singles, two of his hits. Tony Tarasco, maybe I'm behind. How about Bernie Williams? Tarasco, Cohn, Knobloch, Brosius, O'Neill, Williams, Martinez, and Jeter. They all score. 8 runs cross the plate, and 8 runs 6 for the Yanks. And the Yanks win it by a count of 11-5 condensed editing. Until that win, the Yanks had dumped 5 straight games at the Vet. 10 of New York's first 11 hitters reach base. Good ninth inning. Mets trail by 3. Threatening, though. 2 on for Robin Ventura. 2 out. Rips that. John Olerud's coming. Mike Piazza coming. They'll both score. Mets pull within 1. Ventura's only hit of the night. It's going to be it for David Wells. Jim Fregosi goes to get Billy Koch. Luis Lopez pinch running for Ventura. And here's why. Brian McCray rips it. Doubles down the third baseline. Shannon Stewart, a little trouble getting after it. Lopez still coming all the way from first. He's fast. Tied at 3, and we're going to extra innings. Top of the 12th now. Craig Graybeck at bat. Shannon Stewart's at first. Stewart goes on the pitch. Piazza can't throw him out at second. Home plate umpire Randy Marsh calls catcher's interference. And Graybeck gets first base. Bobby Valentine argues and is sent away. Comes back in a great disguise, and he gets to see this in the 14th. Men at second and third, Rey Ordonez. Deep to left over the pulled-in outfield, and it's a winner. Valentine takes off the disguise and celebrates the win. Before the winning hit, Ordonez had gone 0-for-5 in this game. In fact, he ended the ball out of the infield in those 5 at-bats. The Mets have won 4 straight. Out. But first, there's this. Second inning, 2-1 Braves. The pitcher, Ryan Roop's at bat, position. Runner at first, and Roop going to bunt. Pops it in the air. Chipper Jones after it, then not after it so much. Sets him up for the double play. Lets it drop. Tom Glavine starts the double play. Roop never even runs to first. It's fancy. Top of the 10th, tied at 3, and here's Ken Seiko, the pinch hitter. Chops one foul. And watch him on the replay on the swing. The back definitely bothering, not the full normal extension. You see him grimace. Very next pitch. Mike Remlinger. Follow the hostess. Your table is waiting. Ken Seiko. Troubled by that back problem. 11th inning, Brian Hunter pinch hitting now. And Roberto Hernandez comes up in the face after him. Hunter down quickly. Upset by what occurs and reasonably getting his jaw checked out here. Would leave the game under his own power. Just a bruised upper lip. 12th inning, tied at 3. Andrew Jones with the bases loaded. Knocks that thing past the outfield. And Brian Jordan scores the winning run. The Braves get it in 12 innings. The Braves got the winner from Jones after botching a couple scoring chances in
the O's and the Marlins. More rains falling at Pro Players Stadium on Wednesday night, but they did get it in. Top second, score tied at one. Brady Anderson, deep to center. Could it be? Not to be. But a triple. Two runs come in. Anderson 3-for-5 in the game. O's up 3-1. Preston Wilson for Florida leads all rookies with 13 homers. What do we have here? Hardliner, Scott Erickson. Look what I found. Top nine, O's on top, 4-2, two out. Albert Bell hits it to third. Mike Lowell makes a high throw to first. Bell not focusing, not hustling. He's tagged out. Bell then yanked by the manager, Ray Miller. We'll have more on Bell in a moment. Bell displeased. And the O's, however, go on to win by the score of 4-2. Marlins' seven-game winning streak is over. The two. ERA well over five, but Jimmy had the curve going. Damian Jackson, Eric Owens, David Newman. Haynes a one-hitter through four, struck out six in the game. Bottom five, it's 2-0 Oakland. Two men on, one out. Damian Jackson at the plate. Scott Spezio. Then he converts a double play. Haynes out of the jam. A's win it. Three zip. Haynes combines with two relievers on a four-hitter as he wins for just the first time in five road starts on Wednesday. Butch Husky, his 11th of the year. Look at that, 2-0 Seattle. But on the mound for the Mariners, Jeff Acero, he's given up 19 home runs coming in. That's the most allowed in baseball. Bottom two, Angel Echeverria. Yes, please. His fifth of the year, Rockies down 2-1. Bottom three, Edgar Clemente, Roberto's nephew. His first career home run. His uncle had 240. That was his first. Russ Davis here misplays a double play ball. And three batters later, bases loaded, one out. Another double play ball, another error. David Bell throws it away. Two-run score, 4-2 Colorado. After a walk to Vinny Castilla, Echeverria standing in again. There it goes again. He drove in five runs in the game. 424 feet. Gone. 7-2 Colorado. After the inning, A-Rod furious about the events of the preceding inning. That's furious. Top four, here's Ken Griffey Jr. There it goes. 23 on the year for Griffey. That leads the majors, 478 feet. David Bell had only 14 career homers coming into this season. That's his 14th this season. It's a 7-6 game. Kurt Abbott, second of the year. Casero gave up four homers in five-plus innings. Then Dante Bichette. And Bichette dumps one, his 10th of the year, 11-6 in favor of Colorado. David Segee, his 11th on the year. It's 11-7 at this point. Then we had a rain delay, of all things, for over 3 hours. The crowd, sparse at best. Curtis Laskanik, he's a pitcher. Are you kidding me? Looky here. Looky here. 357 feet away in a home run, his first career home run for the pitcher. Scoreboard, please. So the Rocks win at 21 games. And Wednesday night, going against his former team as a Dodger, Tom Goodwin, down he goes. Brown struck out six in the game. Bottom one, Eric Young facing Mark Clark. Deep to left, Rusty Greer. How did he do that? Well, watch it again as Greer goes back and makes a spectacular catch to Rob Young of a home run. Bottom four, no score. Two men on for Eric Karros. 1-2. And Karros way back in Gonzo, his eighth of the year. It's 3-0 at this point in favor of the Dodgers. Bottom six, Brown at the plate with the man on first. Sack bunt. Trinidad Hubbard would go to third on the play. And the next man up is Eric Young. And Young comes through with a base hit, robbed with a home run earlier, but here a single. Hubbard comes in to score, and the Dodgers win it by the score of 7-2. Brown goes eight innings, gives up just two runs, strikes out six. He's now 5-0 at Dodger Stadium this year. Bonds back in the mix. First at bat, bottom one, Bill Miller's at first. Tim Belcher, the batter. Back it comes to Belcher. Throws to Mo Vaughn. Miller would go to third on the play and would later score to make it 1-0 San Francisco. Rich Aurelia here in the bottom of the second. It's deep. Darren Erstad going back, leaps and makes the catch. Top of the third. Mo Vaughn is hit by Chris Brock. Vaughn displeased. Top four, Erstad facing Brock. Comebacker off Brock's glove. Dribbles to first. No play. Brock displeased. Next batter, Brock trying to redeem himself. Matt Walbeck's at the plate. And he lines it back to Brock. This time he makes a grab and doubles up Erstad at first. Top five, we're tied at one. Vaughn's at the plate. Singles to center. Orlando Palmeiro scores. Angels up 2-1, but Vaughn would leave the game with a sore ankle, and that's the same injury that he suffered earlier in the season, still bothered by that bad ankle. Bottom nine, Bonds at the plate, three balls, one strike. Troy Percival calls strike two. Dusty Baker not happy with that. It's now 3-2, and Bonds pops out. Bonds 0-for-4 in the game, and the Angels win it by the final score of 2-1. Bonds after the game said, I felt fast and quick at first, but my third at bat, I was a little weary, and I felt great, however, about.
And there's Randy Johnson. He's tall, looking for his fourth straight win. First inning against Sammy Sosa. He's chopping Brock alive. Third inning, Diamondbacks, a 2-1 lead. Matt Williams, your batter, against Terry Mulholland. Straight away, two-run dong, 17th. Not in this game, that would be a record. 4-1 Diamondbacks. Sixth inning, Sosa again. Cubs are down 7-1. He's choking on a splinter, looking back in disbelief. Eighth inning, Sosa a chance. Home run. 21st of the season, 8-2. Arizona still with the big lead. Now it's been cut to 8-5. Byun Hong Kim. Something flies out of his sleeve. The ball flies past the catcher. It's a pass ball. Now 8-6, the Cubs trail. This would be a continuing story, what that thing was. Same inning, 8-7. Sosa's second at bat in the inning. He's leaving. That's more beer for us. Between innings, Buck Showalter comes out, discusses exactly what it was that flew out of Kim's jersey. Ed Montague walks away with the object. Looks like a hunk of brawny paper towel. Can't exactly scuff the ball with that, but he was tossed. Diamondback.
Cleveland shorthanded. Wright has been admonished for throwing inside. Ron Belliard, what do you have? He's not supposed to do that anymore, but no issues here. Belliard walked. Wright did not unravel. Jeff Cirillo grounds into the 5-4-3 double play. Wright pitched well. Cleveland's offense helped by Richie Sexton. 0 for his last 24. So much for the June swoon. His second home run of the game. He went 3-for-5 in the contest. Richie Sexton. 3-1 Cleveland. Top 8, 5-2 Cleveland. Mark Loretta at the plate. Omar Vizquel. Whoops, his eighth error of the season. Still top 8. 5-3 Indians. Runners on first and third. Alex Ochoa, former Met, former Oriole. Lines went to right. David Justice. I got it. I got it. I don't have it. Burnitz and David Nilsson come in to score. Ties the game at 5. It was ruled a triple, and we go into extra innings. Bottom 10, Jim Thome, the winning run. Jacob Cruz called up from AAA before the game. Base hit. Wins it for the Indians. Final score 6-5. So Jared Wright gave up just 2 hits in 6 innings, but got a no decision. With Ramirez sitting out because of the suspension and the injury to Cordero, Cleveland. Top one, no score runners on first and second. And Bell, who went 4-for-6, singles. Craig Biggio scores. And Houston at this point has a lead by the score of 1-0. And, you know, I think it was the kiss that did it. Top 6, 5-1 Houston, runners on the corners. Jeff Bagwell is storing the game. There it goes, 3-run shot, his 18th on the year. Houston's up by the score of 8-1. Then in the top of the eighth with the score 9-2, Houston, it's Bagwell again. Solo home run is 19th of the year, 10-2 Houston. Bagwell comes to the plate in the top of the ninth, going for the hat trick. Got it. Two-run shot, his 20th home run on the year. And the Astros pound Chicago 13-4. So Bagwell becomes the 12th player in Major League history to hit 3 homers in 2 different games in the same season.
It's 1-0 Reds, 2 on for Jeffrey Hammonds. The middle, a base hit. Brian Johnson, Pokey Reese coming to score on that. 3-0 the Reds. With a fifth inning, middle, Torrey Hunter's your batter. And a man on second. Took a while to develop. The grounder up the middle. Barry Larkin's after it. Restaurant quality play. Gets the play at third. Javier Valentin didn't like the call. We take another look to see how women 18-30 feel about it. Appears the tag did get him. Who knows? The ump says yes. More injury news here for the Twins. Doug Mankiewicz fouls the pitch right off the inside of his leg on the knee. had to be carried off the field and did suffer a contusion to the knee, and the Twins go down in other ways too, losing this one 3-1. The interleague experiment is a complete success so far for Brett Tomko. He's now 7-0 when playing outside his league. Royals top of the fifth, Cardinals down 4-2. Mark McGwire and Terry Matthews combining on a summer science project to see how far a baseball will go. 434 feet, 19th of the year, 476 total, is number 17 all time. Cardinals down 9-7, bases loaded, two out. Ray Lankford, little blooper. David Howard, Edgar Renteria, both coming and scoring, tying the game at 9 apiece. Bottom of 8. The Royals with a 10-9 lead now. Runners on the corners with Joe Randa having a big game. Punches that one through. The check swing works out for him. Giambi comes to score. Randa 5 for 5, two ribs. Royals get 8 in the inning. Go up 17-9. Cardinals down 17-13 now. Bases loaded, two out. Eric Davis, Correa Sanchez, a game over. Royals win it 17-13. The silly score. McGuire's homer.
Brant Brown just hitting 164 in his last 30 games. Base hit to left. Warren Morris scores, and the Pirates up at this point by the score of 2-0. Top of the fifth, it's Brown again. Deep to right. Way back and right. How deep? It's out of the ballpark. Second home run of the year, 9-2 Pittsburgh. Watch it again. The 35th time that the ball has left the park completely at Tiger Stadium since 1938. Top eight, Brown looking to go 5 for 5. Yes, can. 5 for 5 drives and 5 runs. Brown said it was one of the few times he's been in his zone all season. Went 5 for 5, and he's still hitting only 256. Pirates score in every inning but the ninth, and win it 15-3 as they match a season high with 17 hits.
Runs at Brewers, Richie Sexton versus Hideo Nomo, and Richie wins. Into the papal, a 3-run jack, is 11th of the season and 3rd in his last 7 at-bats. 3-1 Indians. It was 3-2 in the 4th. Fundamentals are important, like catching the baseball. Robbie Alomar mangles the easy double play. First error for the 7-time Gold Glover in 65 games. Next batter, Jeff Jenkins against Bartolo Colon. Let's listen in.
Attention, here's an update on tonight's dinner. It was veal. I repeat, veal. The winner of tonight's mystery meat contest is Jeff Jenkins, who guessed some kind of beef.
Anytime you can work meat products into the home run call, you got something going. Alex Ochoa to deep center. Kenny Lofton climbs up the wall, brings it back into play. Marquise Grissom would score 8-3 Milwaukee, 9-3 in the 6th. Dave Nilsson takes Dave Stevens to right, and Dave Stevens didn't want to go to right. His second home run of the night for Nilsson. The Brewers 15-9. Nilsson
expected to play Friday. Still just 25 hits away from 3,000. Chargers are there. Hey, remember us? Well, hometown support. Bottom of the 2nd. 2 on. 2 out.
There they go. Here's the pitch.
Ed Giovinola facing Gil Heredia. Fly ball out there. Ryan Christensen. Oh, no. 1 run will score. 2 runs will score. That's not what Ryan wanted to hear. 2-0 Padres at this point. Still 2-0 in the top of the 6th. 1 out. Bases loaded. John Jaha walked by Sterling Hitchcock. Tony Phillips coming in from 3rd, 2-1 Padres. Still bases loaded, 2 men later. Hitchcock against Tim Raines, he popped him up. Hitchcock getting out of the jam, 2-1 Padres still. Top of the 9th, still 2-1. Here's Trevor Hoffman, pinch hitter, Jason Giambi up. Hoffman, he struck him up. Giambi loses the bat. Padres take this one 2-1. Hoffman with 200 saves now in his career, 25 all-time of